Hello and welcome to another edition of the IFM Student Union Hour. My name is Ibrahim Tijan Fofana. Of course, I'm with my Honorable Minister of Education, which is not as possible, Mr. Aon Safabla. We are here to talk about a very important topic and which will be very, very much important to all students. Mr. Aon Safabla, if you would like to know, what is your take on this biometric registration?
Well, in the first place, as a student in your government, we want to upload the administration to take any one of the steps. It's one of actually, but again, one must not forget the epidemic that is all over the place, which is coronavirus. And again, coronavirus, they would contact. So we are advising the administration of talking to the administration, see how best they can see, how best they can actually counsel and put a hold to this biometric registration. The reason being because coronavirus is all about contact. Once you contact, imagine somebody moving from like coming to school. You have a parent and a student who might come. Your parent stays with you. Then, unfortunately, you contact the virus. You come to my home and then touch the environmental registration. You do an examination. Another student will do the same thing. That student will be able to establish a whole lot of criminal things more than this. So, we are coming here as a super government to actually talk to every student to share this to postpone this to the second semester. And so, then, hopefully, we have a problem.
But that was very quickly and rapidly. So, like, what's in the case of like the student academic affairs, which is normal? Like, there are still some students that are yet to pay that fee. That is supposed to take this examination.
I don't want to get into that much because in case of administration standards, as a government, we get to have to pay. So we are paying to that. So, see if we can help them with that. Actually, minimize the kind of. As a country, so the administration
is
parent in the service
without
touch
quality. So let us say the administration will not accept to expect that. So those that are yet to pay are supposed to lose the administration.
I don't want to push me to that much because yes, talk to them. We are having a lot of impressions now.
So how about the educational aspect? Because students are wondering that they are just compiling some of the notes. So what are some of the skills that you have taken as a minister in that area?
Well, we work on a lot of programs. One of the seminars that engages students as well as open, as I said, inside my organization. Because students have the responsibility to do what is not right. Again, we must know our responsibility as students. We must not interrupt before we attend the examination as well. And they must study very hard and make sure the examination. You know, I fit the originator. They make sarcastic statements all over the place. On the part of the originator, they have to understand that examination is a two-way approach to meet you at the end of the shot. So you have to make the examination of very convincing or something. Actually, think and then write the cover and then publish it.
So as your name implies, they must have had a lot of students that have this as an item or as an item. So, like, what are some of the convincing factors you then ensuring that the CAPS students are being to and very safe for them?
Yes, I've been around a lot of camps. I've been able to motivate us to make sure that our work around all the classes before recess, advising them and talking to them that they will study for them. You move into a camp, it's fine. But again, you have to know that it's not when you guys are set up. Because grouping is maybe the part of having sharing knowledge, you can say, you know, like each one. One must not know everything. But if I come to you and then give me an insight, pam.
So before we conclude with all these talks, like viewers would like to know your final statements towards the administration and it is your pride that you are pleading for them to stop the biometry in as much as it will give so much of health issues. So like what is your last, let me say, motivational statement towards the administration?
Yes, I'm coming from the student and Sumba SU government from the President Kaba. We would like to give a very sensible message to the administration. One thing they have to understand is student make up IPAM. And IPAM can only live without students. And student safety is of high, something that I have to hold to high esteem. Because once student catches coronavirus, the entire country as a whole has that problem. So we are just coming at the supervisory government to see how best they can just put a hold to this for now. We are totally not against the whole process, but let it just put a hold to it for the safety of the nation and the general students' project. So to my college students again, let's know that this is the biggest opportunity we have coming to university. Most of us, our parents, our loved ones, our sisters don't want to see us in university. So you come in, you have to make good chance of this because it's a life-changing program. So college students take a walk, see your study very hard and ensure that you keep yourself safe inside the examination and be in the result of the exam. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, viewers, for watching that video. So please keep sharing our video and keep connecting with us. Once again, my name is Honorable Ibrahim Tijan Papala, and
everyone's so fabulous. Thank you for having me. Bye.